Gentlemen, welcome back to our monthly program, ASEAN Security Challenges and Opportunities in English. My name is Dr. Wilfried, and as you know, I am the Executive Director of the Human Development Forum Foundation, a Thai registered foundation running ASEAN programs here in Bangkok. Today we change our setting and our area a little bit. What we will do is we will have first some news on ASEAN presented by Ms. Aitana. Please, Ms. Aitana.
Education is one of the most important things that can support and sustain ASEAN. Undoubtedly, language education can play a crucial role in further integrating multi-ethnic ASEAN, with people speaking various languages into one community. Understanding this situation, the Thai Basic Education Commission announced last month it had opened 114 language centers with a budget of 9.57 million baht to prepare Thailand for the ASEAN community 2015. According to The Nation, the centers would teach second language Chinese, Japanese, Korean, German, French, and Spanish, as well as four ASEAN languages, Myanmar, Vietnamese, Khmer, and Malayu. Every center would receive different amount of budget, 3.41 billion baht for the Chinese center, 2.50 billion baht for the Japanese, 1.75 million baht for the French, 540,000 baht for the Korean center, 420 baht for the German, and 80 baht for the Spanish. Meanwhile, education centers for Myanmar, Vietnamese, Khmer, and Malayu languages would get 880 baht each. These centers would provide more opportunities for Thai people to be much more competitive in ASEAN, especially when it comes to facing the tightening job market and opportunities. Such a move is applauded by many and should be followed by other ASEAN member states in gearing up for ASEAN community integration.
Thank you, Aitana, for the news. As we see, the Thai Basic Education Commission does a lot of preparation for the ASEAN economic community, and we will have now a short commercial break.
โครงการสมุดกรีนเวย์โครงการเพื่อยกระดับสิ่งแวดล้อมให้คงอยู่ชั่วลูกชั่วหลานตราบนานเท่านานโทเวย์กรีนเวย
์คูปองดิจิตอลทีวีกสทช.มาแล้วค่ะคูปองครับ
ทช.ดูดิจิตอลทีวีที่เขาบอกว่าหนึ่ง
คูปองดิจิตอลทีวีอยู่มาแล้วครับ
วันนี้คูปองมูลค่า690บาทใช้แลกกล่องเซ็ตท็อปบ็อกซ์หรือเป็นส่วนลดซื้อทีวีดิจิตอลได้ที่ศูนย์จำหน่ายที่มีสัญลักษณ์โครงการ
อย่าลืมอ่านก่อนแล้วเตรียมเอกสารให้ครบนะครับ
แจกแล้ว42จังหวัดภายในสิ้นปีนี้ดิจิตอลทีวีดูดีทุกบ้าน
Welcome back to our ASEAN Challenges and Opportunities program in English. Today's main topic is ASEAN and education. In this context, we are happy to have a special guest invited today, Mr. Vorawet Chanlasin from the Asian Institute for Technology, to discuss this important topic with us. Welcome, Khun Vorawet.
Good evening, Dr. Wilfred.
As we all know, ASEAN will grow into one family at the end of this year. And talking about family, it looks like that education should be one of the key issues of the new regional family. Khun Vorawet, what is your first thought if you talk about ASEAN and education? And what kind of role AIT, the Asian Institute for Technology, is playing in that?
Okay, thank you for this question. I think this is a very interesting question about the role of education in ASEAN and AEC. As we know that now we are approaching 2015, and I think the first thing is that the people in ASEAN and also the academic community should consider the culture of ASEAN and also as one identity, and they are using the best practice that the ASEAN community or the ASEAN member states has produced a lot of best practice that can be used elsewhere in the same region. So first of all, the educational institution, including AIT, is giving value to this best practice in ASEAN that can be replicated among the members' country. The second one, when you mentioned about the family, so I would like to look at the parents mm-hmm. as the key people in a family. And when we are looking at the parents, it means in the Asian member state, governments would be playing very important role. So government should start first by setting example and also drive the change to the countries and change to the society and take lead so that the people, the citizen, and so organization in the country can see example and can follow the same thing that the government, you know, guide them to do. The third one, as we know that we are coming to the time that we have to also to integrate ASEAN, so manpower is important. Vocational education is important. We have to produce the manpower to feed into the infrastructure, to feed into the manufacturing and also production houses. But we should not forget that in this vocational training, we should also include the leadership mm-hmm. element into this vocational education. We also should include communication in this vocational education, because communication is the key for the success. So we also should be looking forward that language barrier should not be there, so that we can communicate with organization and people who are in the labor force. They can work in a very effective manner. So all along, these are the three things that education can do for ASEAN integration.
Okay, thank you very much for this comprehensive overview, and especially the language brings back also the first news from Aitana, how the language institutes are formed in Thailand. The second part, what I want to discuss with you, if we have this kind of education, what really organizations like AIT and other country organizations can contribute to the ASEAN vision of one community and one identity?
Yes, AIT can be one example that perhaps the member states can follow, because the AIT is the international organization. We can say AIT is a regional organization, academic institution that have the set of the environment look like the environment that ASEAN integration has to be. So AIT, with students from many countries, many nationalities, and also faculty members are there. But we are, although we are having different culture, we are having diversity, but we are united as AIT as one. So that's the first thing. AIT can be example of the organizational setup. The second, perhaps, the networking part of AIT. Mm-hmm. AIT have alumni, over 20,000 alumni member that working in different organizations in different countries. And these alumni already carry a lot of knowledge, a lot of best practice, and a lot of know-how to be able to translate into the real world and also to solve problems. So having a network of alumni is also an example that ASEAN perhaps can replicate by sharing the know-how through the network, through the strong network of the professional group. So that is the second one. The third one would be that the leadership, because in AIT we are not only looking at the academic component of education, but we are also looking at the soft skill, especially the leadership. So AIT is producing the leaders that can, first of all, run the organization like international organization, like ASEAN organization or other inter-development, international development agencies there. So we are also producing leader that can drive change. And the last one is that AIT also have example of international collaborations with international organizations from various angles of the world, so that this platform is giving a chance, opportunity for AIT and people in ASEAN, different professional groups to share best practice and knowledge and know-how among themselves and also to the outsiders as well.
Okay, thank you. This is very comprehensive. Coming back again to the leadership, which is still one of the key points, as now just recently one of the great leaders of ASEAN passed away, Lee Kuan Yew, and we saw that there's always a lack if a big leader pass away and big shoes are left to fill. Looking at the whole topic what we are talking about, what is your really golden thought on ASEAN 2015 and education?
I think integration is the key. And 2015 is ending very soon. Integrating economics part of ASEAN, I feel, is not enough. I think now ASEAN bodies, ASEAN organizations, and ASEAN divisions should also look into how they could integrate ASEAN within other pillars, socio-cultural pillar, and also the security pillars, plus the connectivity part that they just established very recently. So I think it is very important to look beyond economic pillar, because in the future, sustainability is very important. And I think that the other two pillars serve well to the sustainability of the ASEAN integration.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think this is exactly what ASEAN wants. Three pillars working together to have a stable basis for the roof of ASEAN community. Thank you very much, Khun Warawet. We are working already many years together.
We know each other.
Good, and we will work together on a better ASEAN and on a broader perspective of ASEAN in the context of the three pillars.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
เขาเป็นสมุดสิ่งที่มีค่าสำหรับพวกเขาได้ด้วยแนวคิดการใช้ทรัพยากรธรรมชาติอย่างรู้คุณค่าและให้เกิดประโยชน์สูงสุดทำให้ดอนเมืองโทเวได้เริ่มดำเนินโครงการสมุดกรีนเวย์โครงการเพื่อยกระดับสิ่งแวดล้อมให้คงอยู่ชั่วลูกชั่วหลานตราบนานเท่านานโทเวกรีนเวย
์คูปองดิจิตอลทีวีกสทช.มาแล้วค่ะคูปองครับคูปองดิจิตอลทีวีมาแล้วครับ
วันนี้คูปองมูลค่า690บาทใช้แลกกล่องเซ็ตท็อปบ็อกซ์หรือเป็นส่วนลดซื้อทีวีดิจิตอลได้ที่ศูนย์จำหน่ายที่มีสัญลักษณ์โครงการ
อย่าลืมอ่านก่อนแล้วเตรียมเอกสารให้ครบนะครับ
แจกแล้ว42จังหวัดภายในสิ้นปีนี้ดิจิตอลทีวีดูดีทุกบ้าน
บริษัท IRPC จำกัดมหาชนพร้อมก้าวสู่ผู้นำด้านปิโตรเคมีและการกลั่นครบวงจร
Welcome back to our ASEAN Challenges and Opportunities program. Let me wrap up what we discussed up to now. First of all, the family values and education, like outlined, are depending also a lot of language. As Aitana and Khun Warawet moved on, telling us this language is part of the integration, then we have to look for some more practical examples, as the whole thing was a little bit too theoretically now. So Khun Warawet, please give us some practical examples. What do you do in this context?
In AIT, you know, we have the example, for example, the student unions in AIT. So the student union in AIT, this body is actually supporting the governance of running the academic institution. And the body of the student union also comprised of different members from different countries that represent there. And these are the things that we set the environment of the diversity of culture, belief, and also the way of doing things. But at the end of the day, this body of the student union in AIT can give direction for AIT to run, how they engage the students and also how they produce, you know, the research works and also other projects work according to the interest of the region by you know, compromising the interests of the individual country into the regional point of view. Another example in terms of the international collaboration, AIT has been passed through a lot of experience through years. Say, for example, in 80s, AIT was the hub of the best practice. We have brought the know-how from Germany through the GIZ support, and that we grew the practice of the urban planning and urban environment management. So with the international collaboration with the international development agency like GIZ, now in Thailand and in many countries in ASEAN, they have already replicated the model of the urban development, urban planning into the region. So that is one example. Another example is the subject area related to the coastal zone management, which was the collaboration with the Sweden and also the Denmark government during early 90s. So this coastal zone management was a new idea, a new theory to the region. But after having the intervention from the countries like this, so we promote the conservation of natural resources through this initiative. So you can see that we build up the knowledge through collaborations.
Thank you very much. And in this context, we also work for years together in anti-corruption programs, leadership programs. So HDFF and AITE have a lot and close relationship. For today, this was a good idea and a good impression to show how much education will influence the idea of one community and one identity of ASEAN 2015. Because best practices region-wide collected and then put in practice by organizations like AIT are very important. And also the key point is that the networking will give a great chance of having leaders all over ASEAN trained in a similar way of approaching problems and solving problems. This was a very important session. Thank you very much, Kumbhoravet Aitana, and see you next month again in our English program on ASEAN 2015 challenges and opportunities. Bye-bye.